All right, so a lot of people have been asking me, Josh, if Biden's health is going down and it's so terrible, then why don't they just invoke the 25th Amendment now and put Harris in? Great question. So let me explain to you at least what I think is behind all this and why they're not going to do it. If you remember, Biden's health has always been a question. You can go back to the second term of Barack Obama, or at least his run-up to that second term, and the Democrats were worried and thinking, okay, should we replace Biden on the ticket, because he was already mentally slipping, and that was all the way back then. Fast forward to today, and you saw that terrible performance he had with Donald Trump in the presidential debate, and even worse was the media tour he did after that to try to fix the problem, just made it worse. So everybody's like, okay, well, you know, obviously Biden has a problem. And that was when all this conversation started to ensue. Should we replace him? And they were wondering who they should replace him with, because obviously all the Democrats knew it should never be Harris. So they were floating like, you know, Newsom or Kelly or whoever, right? Well, anyway, that's not the point. I've already made videos on that. Fast forward to now. And now we're in this position where people are literally wondering, is Biden even alive? We haven't seen him in 6 or 7 days. They're asking for proof of life. They did this sort of weird, really suspicious way to pull out of the campaign. You know, I already did a video on that too, so look that up. But then yesterday, Biden makes a phone call into the Harris campaign to talk to the staff and say, hey, I'm watching you, kid. And Biden insiders were like, you know what? We don't want to say this because it would make the right-wingers just fanatical about it. But yeah, we don't think that was Biden. We think that was AI. That was from Biden insiders. So now it's been 24 hours. There has been a bunch of investigative analysis done on that phone call. And it turns out there's a 98% chance that that phone call was artificial intelligence. Not kidding. Go look it up. You can find it all over Twitter, even if the mainstream media is not going to cover it, for obvious reasons. But really, and if it's 98% chance, sure, there's a 2% chance that it's really Joe Biden. However, at 98%, that's when Maury Povich comes out and says, you are not the baby daddy voice. So pretty sure it's AI. So why don't they just invoke it? If they know he's going downhill anyway, why don't they just invoke the 25th? Some people are saying they won't do it because that means Harris will only have one more time to run because he can't be president more than 2 terms. That's really not entirely true. So let me explain how that works real quick. If a vice president assumes presidential powers under the invocation of the 25th Amendment and becomes president, as long as that person is president less than 2 years, it doesn't take away from their ability to run 2 more times. So in reality, they could be president for almost 10 years. So that's that. So again, if that's true, and it is, then why don't they do it? Because they would lose. If somehow President Biden is taken out of office and President Harris is put in office as president, of course, then what's going to happen? Well, the world has already gone to crap on a cracker under Joe Biden. Everybody knows that, including the Democrats. So you would have this continuation of his administration, but now under a less capable person. And I'm not saying that because she's a woman. I'm not saying that because, well, Josh, don't you know she was DA and a senator and VP? How much more qualified do you have to be? Well, I'm just going off what the Democrats told us. If you go back in time and look at the presidential run-up to 2020, this is the same lady that the Democrats warned us not to vote for. They spent millions of dollars telling us not to vote for her. How effective was it? Well, when she ran for president, she won 0 states in the primaries. Literally none. Nada. Zip, zilch, zero. Which means if she does get the party's nomination, she will be the first candidate in modern history to win 0 primary states and still get the front of the ticket. So anyway, I digress. So what that means is, if they're going to put her in the presidential chair now, it might cost them the election in November, Because that gives her 4 months or so to totally screw this thing up even worse, which would make it impossible for them then to have control for 4 years. They would rather weekend at Bernie's, Joe Biden, and keep that thing going as long as they can, so that way that they can have Harris have a better chance. Why would they do that? Well, watch my other videos. Thank you so much for all the subscriptions and follows wherever you're watching this thing. I know in the past 4 days, our videos have been viewed over 12 million times. Thank you for that. And always go to livethelogicallife.com and follow everything else we're up to.